Hi, welcome to horizonhobby.com. Today we've got another preview. This is a 15 size pylon racer. Now, Pete Bergstrom is the product developer for this LR-1A 15E ARF, and it has some interesting features that I think we haven't seen in a model like this. This is kind of a first time that I've seen something like this, especially for Horizon. So, Pete, I'm seeing a very nice airplane here. I know you've been in the middle of the development of this thing for some time, so
right.
Let's talk about it. You're calling it a 15E airplane.
It's a 15-sized airplane. The goal of the project was to come up with a really great-looking sport airplane that was fast and aerobatic for sport aerobatics. It does loops, about 400-foot diameter loops, and just goes forever.
I know. It goes over the top as high as you want to go.
As high as you can see and as high as you want to go, right. And it's set up for two different power systems. It flies great on a Power 15 with a 3S battery and a 1010 propeller. At the same time, we wanted to work with the racing organization, which is the NMPRA. They're looking to develop a new electric Formula One class, and so this airplane was built to those specifications. It's actually the first of the airplanes out for that class. Put a Power 25 in here. We've got a new Power 25 with a 1250 kV, an 8.8 propeller, and a 4S battery in here, and it'll do 110 plus miles an hour.
What are you saying is the right pilot skill for this?
It's definitely an intermediate level guy.
Certainly not beginner.
Especially
we know that.
With the more powerful motor, there's a lot of torque involved, and so takeoffs can be a little bit squirrely until you get a chance to manage the rudder really well. And if you practice, then you can do that. In the sport configuration, it's much, much more docile, and so a good intermediate pilot, anybody who's done fairly quick low-wing airplanes can fly this airplane with no problem whatsoever.
Let's talk a little bit about the radio that it requires. This is, I assume, a four-channel airplane.
It's a simple four-channel airplane. Uses only three servos. We've got one servo driving both ailerons mounted into the middle of the wing, one servo for the elevators, one servo for the rudder. So a simple four-channel setup is really all that you need. ESC plugs into the throttle, of course.
So it's three servos and an ESC. What else do you need to finish the airplane?
You need to a motor, the speed control. With the Power 15 side setup, a 40-amp speed control is more than enough. We use our E-flite 40-amp speed control and a radio system. When you want to move up to the higher power, you want to go to a 60-amp speed control.
Okay. Now, I know it's got a very nice-looking painted pilot inside the canopy, and all that's very nicely fared in. Is the pilot already installed in the
comes
kit?
Comes pre-installed in the kit. The hatch comes this way right off of the fuselage. And the hatch comes out this way, and the battery gets loaded in and out right here.
Oh, it makes for a very clean radio installation, easy to get at, and the battery's easy to exchange. Aluminum landing gear?
Aluminum landing gear, fiberglass wheel pants. We've got a pretty trick aluminum axle assembly that was designed specifically for this setup, and it works beautifully.
That's nice, because sometimes the wheel pants are kind of a pain.
They can be, sure.
If you got something like that, it simplifies the operation or the mounting them and things like that. Well, it looks like it should be relatively easy to get together without too much trouble. I know you've got a couple of optional parts as well. E-flite's also been known for having spare parts for their models, and the LR-1A is no exception. Now, Pete, this one, though, has some what I'd call optional accessories. What have we've got here? These cowlings and
the spare parts. You can buy every single part in the kit painted exactly the way it comes out of the kit if you need to replace something that you have. But if you get into racing, get some local guys at your local club, and you want to go around the poles together and do some flying and racing, maybe not everybody wants to have the same looking airplane. So what we've come up with is an all-white cowl, all-white wheel pants, and an unpainted hatch assembly. Essentially all the parts that are painted, so that if you want, you can strip the airplane of the covering, add your own trim scheme, and then either apply decals or paint to these items so that you can have a unique airplane out of the field.
Personalize it for you.
Personalize it, exactly.
So you can tell that airplane's apart in the air.
Right.
I know that one. Hey, Pete, I know pylon racers generally don't use the kind of control throws that maybe sport models do. Can you kind of demonstrate the amount of travel that we need
Sure.
set up this airplane?
Because of the speed of the airplane, the control surface has become a lot more effective. And so instead of needing 30 and 40 degrees of control surface movement to get a nice, good roll rate out of this, the aileron movement, is really only this much. That's our low rate. That's what I usually use for racing. And the high rate is not a whole lot more than that.
Maybe so a quarter inch aileron travel up and
right.
down.
The manual goes over exactly that. But what I want to try to stress is start with the manual settings and then decide on your own flying skill whether or not, or your flying style, whether or not you want to increase it. The elevator is very similar. This is the low rate elevator. This is more than enough to do some great loops and aerobatics with it. This is high rate. You might need this a little bit for landing, especially if you've got a small field where you can want to really slow the airplane up or some tighter loops, but you really don't need anything more than that throw in the elevator.
I know that this airplane, it is just great fun to land. It comes down and rolls out. It's beautiful. I think it's because of the length. And the full-size airplane's almost like a model airplane in terms of the relationship of wingspan
right.
and the tail and the size of the surfaces and things. So,
sure.
I think you got a very, very nice airplane here, Pete, and I'm pretty sure there's going to be a lot of people that are thanking you for this one. I'm kind of anxious to see my first electric pylon race.
I'm looking forward to that, too.
Maybe we can get some guys around here and go out and demo it or something, you think? Mm-hmm. Well, this will be kind of fun. It's a new aspect to the hobby, electric pylon racing. Just one more thing coming from Horizon Hobby and E-flite. The developers here are working on ideas for you guys all the time. I hope you appreciate the opportunity that we get to talk to Pete, and I hope you appreciate the work that they've done here. Thank you for visiting, and I hope you return to horizonhobby.com very soon.